Hey there guys and gals, I am Jim Bob and welcome back to Fendt Farm. We have had a little bit of a technical issue. I was just reviewing the audio for episode 16, the previous episode, and the microphone did not record at all. So, there was a 48 minute long video of footage with just a lot of crackling and hissing and no voiceover work whatsoever. So, using a different mic, as you can probably tell, I've dug out my old Rock Band mic from years and years ago on my PS3, and still have my microphone stand. Sometimes it pays never to throw things away. So let's catch you up on what happened in the missing episode. For the record, this is episode 16. I've just deleted the footage of the last hour's worth of gameplay that you haven't seen, so, and renamed this one. So, we emptied out all of the silage here. That's now completely gone. It made us a nice bit of money, and we used that money to buy field 3. And as you can see, I've already started working the borders. I have used the roller to clean the edges up a little bit and make it nice and smooth, apart from this tiny little bit just here, and nice and clean. And now it's time to finish ploughing our new addition and then get it all ready and prepped. So seeded, fertilised, etc, etc. So while that's doing that, I'm going to start the timer. There we go. Of course, I look away for 2 seconds and I immediately start drifting. So yeah, a little bit annoyed and disappointed that we lost all that footage there. I don't remember exactly what I was rambling on about, but there was a lot of footage of me making a complete pig's ear of setting up my conveyor belt system. So maybe it's not a bad thing that episode is being consigned to the waste bin. Maybe it helps present, you know, keep the illusion that I know what I'm doing alive a little bit longer. So yeah, new microphone then. As I say, I was looking at the possibility of getting a Blue Yeti. Looking into the pricing and so on and so forth, and looking at something like a pop filter as well to try and cut down on the hissing for my S's. Because I have noticed that it's quite prominent in my videos. And I saw a picture of just a regular condenser mic, you know, being used in the photo art and the promotional photos of the pop filter that I was looking at. And it made me think, I think I still have one of those. Because, you know, years and years ago I used to play Rock Band on the PS3 and Guitar Hero and all that jazz. And I bought the complete Rock Band set. So I had the microphone, I had the drum kit, the guitars, and the Guitar Hero guitars as well. And I bought myself a basic mic stand for when I was doing the vocal stuff, and I've kept it all these years because I just had it by the side of my bed, and a little clip-on desk lamp was attached to the mic stand. Well, that lamp has been broken for a while. I just haven't got around to replacing it, but I just kept hold of the mic stand because, you know, I'm terrible when it comes to throwing things away. And while my drums and my guitars are gone and the games are gone, if for some reason I kept the microphone. I have a box in my cupboard full of technical stuff from various different game systems and bits and bobs and wiring and cabling that I've had over the years. I thought, I think I might still have my Rock Band mic. So I dug around in my cupboard last night and found the microphone. I'm using a pair of socks as a pop filter at the moment. I have ordered one that should arrive tomorrow, so hopefully that'll help improve distortion, but I should be coming through louder, clearer, easier to hear using this new mic. When I say new mic, old mic. It's a better mic. It's a USB plug-in, but it's a cheap one because it's the one that they gave away with the Rock Band instrument pack. So it's not a fantastic quality studio mic, but it's certainly going to be an improvement on the headset. You know, I did some testing while chatting to a friend on some multiplayer last night, and then listened to the recording to see how good it sounded and if there was much of an improvement. And the other great thing is that while the other headset that I've used, my PX4s, had the better mic than my my Elite 800s, because they needed a cable to plug in to the bottom of my joypad, sometimes if the Bluetooth connection got a little bit screwy on my pad and my pad played up a little bit, it would distort the audio. And also, if the cable wasn't quite perfect in the right position, then it could screw up my audio. This isn't the first time I've had to scrap episodes and re-record footage because there's been no audio. Had to do that with my No Man's Sky. I had to completely scrap the first four episodes because the first episode and a half had no audio whatsoever. I found this Rock Band mic, hooked it up, got it all working, and it'll do for now. In the future, as the channel grows, I will invest in a proper studio mic, but this is good enough for now, I think, you know. So in terms of the channel, we have now officially passed the 100 subscriber mark. I went to bed a couple of nights ago on 99 subscribers, woke up the next morning on 102, and then when I checked this morning, we're at 109. So the channel is definitely still starting to pick up some new views. That's great. It's fantastic. Thank you to all of you who have subscribed recently. You are the reason that I'm doing these videos. And if you didn't continue to watch and enjoy the content that I'm putting out, then you know I would probably end up start to lose a little bit of motivation. So the fact that the channel is growing and people are stumbling across my videos, be it through YouTube searching or just random popping up in the recommendations, or if you've seen my videos posted on Facebook, and decided to subscribe to the channel, I thank you for that. I really do. It is a huge motivational boost to keep going and keep plugging away. And I've had a couple of videos that have gone quite big for a novice YouTuber like myself. My Big Bud DLC video that I released is now closing in on 3,000 views, which is amazing. That's fantastic. I don't even have to plug that video anymore. It's just gaining a couple of hundred views a day, which is which is brilliant. Absolutely thrilled with that. My map tours are quite popular. I've got a map tour of American Outback that's closing in on 1,000 views. That map is actually, I did start a series on American Outback, posted the first two videos and then took them both down 20 minutes later as soon as I found out that the map is being overhauled. And redesigned to fix some bugs, change the layout of some of the fields, add in an extra field on top of that as well, and it will mean a new save file is required. So having recorded 5 episodes and launched the first two, they survived all of 20 minutes before I discovered all of that information and promptly took them down again. That series will still come, but obviously we're going to wait until the map is patched, and then we'll get it restarted with the new map. The changes will allow us to link fields together, make large areas. It's added in some nice big storage areas for the impending Big Bud DLC that's going to come out next month. So, as I said, fix some bugs with the map as well. So, looking forward to getting back and up and running with American Outback again. I have some very definite plans, as you know. For those of you that saw the videos that were up for the first 20 minutes or so and then wondered what had happened, that's what happened. That's why they went down. I have seen the changed map, actually. I have posted a picture of it on my Facebook page, Jim Bob Plays Games on Facebook. So if you want to see what it looks like, then head on over to Facebook, check out my page, and you'll find the details of the changes, plus an image of the updated map as well. Also been considering reviving my interest in Star Trek Online. It's a game that was launched on PC about 6-7 years ago, and did pretty well on PC, and it's still going. And it came out on console for both Xbox and PlayStation 4 last September, and I started playing it about a week after it was launched, and I have sunk a lot of hours into that game. A lot of hours. Bought quite a few premium ships, and I played it so much that I kind of burnt myself out on it a little bit. So I haven't really played it since the end of January, beginning of February time, at least not on a regular basis. I did the winter event, and then I did the anniversary event to get my Krennim timeship, and I haven't really played it since. But they have released the Agents of Yesterday expansion, so there's plenty of new content for me to play on that. And obviously I can do some reviews and videos on the premium ships that I own, and some of the specialty ships that I've acquired from events. And you know, if you guys are interested in seeing that, then let me know in the comments section. You know, feed the down below, and I will you know, I will definitely look at bringing that to the channel. I'm probably going to bring it into the channel in some form, maybe the occasional video here and there, maybe just reviewing some of the premium stuff that I already own. And if they prove popular enough, I may start playing the game more regularly and actually doing a little series on it. But I think for now, if I do add it to the channel, then it will just be a kind of an occasional video, maybe one a week kind of thing. Just to add in some footage, so you can see how different, because it looks very different in terms of, at least in terms of the layout, looks very different on console to PC, for obvious reasons. You know, with console it has a completely different control system, because it's reliant on a control pad, a D-pad rather than or a joypad, as I should say, rather than a keyboard and mouse combo that the PC users use. So there's definitely some worthwhile footage there from what I have in the game already. It's just I'm umming and ahhing as to whether or not I really want to, you know, revive it in a big way. So your feedback will help me decide on that. You know, if it's something that you guys want to see, let me know, and I will look at maybe reviving my interest in that game a little bit more extensively than what I have planned right now. So this field 3 here alongside 2 and 4, 5, 6 and 7, 8 fields means that we now have 4 pretty good sized fields for crops. We still have field 33 down by the sheep that is, still has grass on it for now. We're going to leave that as a grass field for a little while. But what we're also going to do is on the next round we're actually going to make some silage bales to make working the feed a little bit easier. So we'll have some hay bales stacked up, we'll have some silage bales stacked up, and then rather than baling straw, what we're going to do is we're going to collect up loose straw, and we're going to buy a hayloft, and we're going to put that in near the cows, and that will be our storage area for hay. And that way we can add in, you know, enough hay and control the mixture by adding that hay, that straw, to our hay and silage in the feeder wagon, so that the mix ratio doesn't get too bad, and we can actually make a nice batch of silage. I have also heard, and I'm going to be testing this theory out as well, because I don't know if it actually works or not, I've seen somebody posting on Facebook in one of the groups that I'm in that you can just mix hay and silage together in a feed wagon, and if you have straw on the ground, straw bedding, then you don't need to add straw, but it will still fill up your power food. I don't know if that's true. It sounds a little hokey to me, but we'll try it. We'll put a little bit in once we've let the feed mixtures go down a little bit. We'll try it and see if it does actually work. I personally don't think it does. I mean, we put in. I know it doesn't, does it? We know straight away that it doesn't, because we had straw down for our cows before we started adding the feed. And we had hay and we had silage in our mixing wagon, and it unloaded the two of them separately, and it didn't move the power feed bar. It just added in hay and silage and filled those bars up. So yeah, it is a bit of hokey. Doesn't work. So we won't waste our time with that. But we are going to, as I say, we are going to put a hayloft in near the cows and keep our loose straw in there. And that way, we can actually add in however much we need to get the mix right without putting in too much, which would be what would happen if we use a bale. And it saves us having to scoop up piles off the floor like we did the last time we fed the cows. So that's the immediate plans for this farm. Also, in terms of mod news, Thornton Farm went live today. I have done a map tour, and that will be up on the channel before you see this video. So if you haven't already checked it out, do go ahead and make sure to check out the map tour of Thornton Farm, the console version. And it's a little bit stripped down compared to the PC version. There's some custom scripts and animations and mods like the mud mod and the chop straw that have been taken out for the console version because we can't have those scripts in there. But the basic layout of the farm is identical. The basic features of it are identical. It's just some of the glossy stuff that we don't have. So the tour will show you where everything's laid out. Some really nice little touches. Some interesting choices that are in there. It'll also show you the gold nuggets are in there as well, so make sure you do check out that video. Okay, so we got maybe we can do this in one pass. Might need two, let's see. I'm going to hire a worker so he stays in a straight line for this bit. Looks like we might just get away with doing the entire strip. Might have to reposition him in a second. Let's see. Yeah. We'll just reposition just a touch. Not too much. And there we go. So we got a new field there. Field 12. Sorry, field 12. Field 3 added to our farm collection. So we've got some extra land here. That'll be excellent. Oh, we are going to have a little patch left over. I shouldn't have repositioned him. Should have left him where he was. He would probably have been okay. Never mind. We'll do that little strip manually. It'll only take us a few seconds. So we'll need to bring our fertilizer spreader up. Put some pellets down on this field, and then we'll seed it. And then we'll spread it again, and then that'll catch us up with the rest of the fields. And we have one pound. It says euro. It should be pound. That's because I've been doing a little bit of work on a European themed map, so I need to change the currency. Let's do that now. Sorry, back to pounds. There we go. We don't want your euros. So let's go remove this. In fact, actually, we can pick up the roller at the same time. So yeah, in terms of new mods, we had Thornton Farm go live today. We also had an update for the low loader bale trailer that has caused so many issues for people with it glitching all over the place. That has been patched to apparently fix the issue with bales and keep them stable. Haven't tried it yet. I will definitely run that through my test farm once I have some bales. I'll stack them and I'll see how stable that is. And we also had the Joskin tippers, the small Joskin tippers, come out from Black Sheep Modding. There's two different designs. There's a black body with a white frame, and then there's a traditional yellow body with a green frame. Colour schemes. You can also add a wooden loading wall around the top of the trailers as well, and they are interconnectable, so you can actually have more than one, daisy chain together, which is great. And I should have cleaned this, so let's do a lap. Go back and wash the equipment off before we put it away. Let me know what you think of the new audio in terms of the new microphone. Is it better for you guys? Are you hearing me clearer and a little bit louder? Hopefully you are. If my voice volume tends to fluctuate a little bit, it's because I'm still getting used to using this new microphone. And if I lean back a little bit like this and then lean in a bit too close like this, then my voice is going to get a little bit loud or a little bit quiet. So you'll have to bear with me on the next couple of videos that I release, just while I get used to this new microphone and find a comfortable position. Not having a PC or professional editing software means that I don't have a mixing station for sound quality. I kind of just plug and play and hope for the best. It seems to have worked so far, for the most part. Okay, so let's put our plow away, and then we'll park the roller next to it. Oops, wrong one. There we go. Probably should have done the roller first, never mind. There we go. So that's our field equipment put away there. We need this guy to start seeding. He is our designated seeder. We are going to have to refuel him though. He's running a little bit low. As you can see, the tank is in the red now. So we'll park this guy up here and we'll fuel him. And while he's doing that, we'll go and fertilize the field. In fact, actually, before we do that, come on, I'll connect. There we go. We're going to have to refill this. Let's check the fertilizer stage on the other fields. Yes, they've all been fertilized once. And that was before they were planted. That's fine. So what we'll do is, where are the fertilizer tanks? There aren't any down here, are there? Yes, there are. That's the liquid. There's the solid. There we go. So yeah, a little bit disappointed about the seed not going in there. That's a bit of a shame. I mean, it's not the end of the world, but you expect it to work. This is an official piece of content. You expect it to work properly. I did actually find another bug as well while I was doing my American Outback recording. The sprayers. Where are the sprayers? There they are. So we have this piece of equipment here. This is the original one that we got in-game with a maintenance cost of £220 per day. Do you want to see how much the Coon version costs? It's a little bit more. Oh, we have a typo. It's 2,000. £2,000 a day. Someone's put an extra zero in there by mistake, by the look of it. That's horrendously expensive. £2,000 a day is more than the largest combine, I believe. Let's see, the CR10. Yeah, see, look, that's 1760. It costs more to run a tow-behind sprayer than it does to run a, you know, the biggest combine harvester that we have in-game. It's definitely got to be a typo. Someone's put an extra zero in by mistake there. Put a decimal point in the wrong place. So let's close our cover up. We'll get this guy to start spreading his fertilizer on the fields for us. And now that we have cows and pigs up and running, we're starting to build up a supply of manure very slowly, but we are starting to build up some manure. So in future we will actually be able to get rid of this unit entirely, hopefully, and use a combination of slurry, manure and a weeder to add all three stages of fertilization to our fields. That's the long-term plan. In reality, while we might be able to do that every other harvest or so, it's going to take time until we have lots of animals for those tanks to and manure pits to refill. So we have to keep using the expensive fertilizer system to start with. So actually, while he's doing that, that's the right tractor, isn't it? There's the 800. So I was using the wrong one for a second then. So while he's doing that, we're going to drive this guy over and hook him up to the seeder. We're going to do another full harvest of soybeans. That's what we've put down already. Or was it canola? We will check before we start seeding whether we've put down soybeans or canola, because I can't remember. Let's jump into the in-cab. I've also changed my driving position a little bit. The view angle was at 60 degrees. I've reduced that to 55 degrees, so I'm sitting slightly further forward in the cab. So it's a little bit easier to see. I'm adjusting bit by bit, so I'm going to gradually reduce that down to 50 to sit even further forward. So that these smaller tractors, I don't get these pillars on the smaller tractors blocking my line of sight when I turn my head sideways. But it's a very strange experience when you're used to a particular visual setting, and then it changes. And if it changes drastically enough, it can be very disorientating. Looks like we were planting canola. Let's check. Oh, we planted canola on 2. So we'll plant canola on 3 as well. So we've got 2 fields of soybeans, and we'll have 2 of canola. That works for us. So I'll open up the sprayer at the seeder. There we go. We'll get this guy started, and then while he's doing that, we will take over this and we will spray. We'll spread the rest of the seeds, the rest of the fertilizer on the other fields. We'll come back and we'll do this one again, and we'll also do all the other ones as well. So save a little bit of wages there by doing it ourselves. And given that we spent over 8,000, or around 8,000 on fertilizer there, we kind of need to save a bit of money where we can. This stuff isn't cheap. See, how are we doing for time? We've got about 15 minutes or so left on this episode, so we've got time to at least fertilize the rest of these fields. We should have enough time to get this field seeded in that time as well, I would have thought, which would be good. That'll mean that we'll be able to speed time up a little bit and do some weeding, and we can also start doing some prep work for getting our silage bales ready for our next round of feeding the cows. The money that we made from selling the silage in the now lost footage was pretty substantial. I took out a small loan and was able to pay that back, plus even more. Because of the money that we made from that silage. and then we used it to buy that field. So if we look at our financial situation, our loan is at 130,000. You know, that's not bad. You know, we've paid for field three there, and it hasn't really done a lot in the way of harming our financials. And having that extra field means that, you know, we're going to be getting additional crop every harvest from now on. It means that you know, we can actually get a little bit more variety in our crop as well. So whereas before we had three fields and we did them all with soybeans, now we've got four fields. We can do two with one crop and two with another, which is exactly what we're doing this time round. We've got two with soybeans and two with canola for this next harvest. Right on the edge there. There we go. Just overlap a little bit, just to be safe. Just gonna grab a drink. Bear with me a second. There we go. Gotta keep the old tonsils lubricated. We've got a couple of pallets of wool that we can look at selling as well, just to improve our bank balance slightly. Making a little bit of a mess on this field here. There we go. Let's see if we can stay in a straight line down here. Yeah, we have what, two or three pallets of wool. I did look at selling some wool earlier. It may or may not have been recorded. I honestly can't remember if that was in the deleted footage or if that one's been, you know, going to be broadcast or not. The price at the time was pretty terrible, so I decided to hang on to it for a little while. But we can check and see if the price has improved. You know, we can maybe set up a storage area for our wool, so that we can stockpile it and then just sell it in one big load. Now, what else can I let you know about? Oh yes, while we were talking about mods earlier, Giants on their official forums have now launched a new thread, which they'll be manning themselves, called Console Mods in Testing. Pull up the details of the thread. They announced it on Twitter yesterday, and so I've done my best to spread the link where I can. Reach the edge of the field, there we go. Let's head back to the gate. So yeah, here we go, opening up the thread. Oh, excuse me, opening up the thread. It's, yeah, Console Mods currently in testing. That's the name of the thread. It's an info thread. Basically, it just lets us know which mods are being currently tested and what's due for release, or what is currently available, you know, in the latest batch of releases. So following the release of Thornton Farm and the update for the flatbed trailer and the release of the Joskin trailers today, the mods that are currently being tested include the long-awaited and eagerly anticipated Mack trailers for from Black Sheep Modding, the big 70,000 litre grain trailers. These were delayed just simply because Giants were pretty busy. I think these ones have been sprayed already. That one certainly has. Look at it. I must have forgotten to do that one when I first... Let's just catch that little bit that I missed there. Yeah, I must have forgotten to do that one when I first needed to. There's a patch over there as well. Yeah, there's a small bit just here as well, so we'll get this bit. There we go. That's okay, we can always just come back and weed that one twice, but we'll work on this one here. So yeah, yesterday when they launched this topic, the mods that were announced on it were the stone shovel grab mod, which can also double up as a weight. It's a nice concept, it works well on PC. Kind of seems a little bit redundant on console, seeing as we'll never be able to, or at least as things stand, we can't pick up stones because loose stones don't exist. Because it's a script mod. It kind of seems a little bit redundant. But hopefully, you know, things will change and that will become a little bit more relevant in the future. We'll have to wait and see. We also got a safety weight, which kind of, you know, acts like a front bumper. I can show you that in a moment. Oh, actually, no, I can't show you that because I didn't install it on this particular farm. And there was something else as well, I think. But the mods that were announced yesterday that were in testing and then were released, they were the ones that were announced as released, and they announced as in testing yesterday was Thornton Farm and the Joskin trailers. And I think they announced the low loader as well. The point I'm making is they were only in testing, it would seem, for 24 hours, which means there's a very good chance that I'm recording this. This is a Thursday afternoon / early evening. It's a very good chance that tomorrow, being Friday, the mythical mod Friday that I keep saying doesn't exist, and now it's starting to look as though it might actually potentially exist. Although hopefully today's release of Thornton Farm will help dispel this myth of mod Friday. Maybe we'll get our Mac trailers tomorrow. I really, really hope so. I mean, I'm really looking forward to these trailers. I want to try them, I want to use them. I want to see what they look like, you know, completely loaded. I want to see how a truck performs with, you know, 300,000 litres or 200,000 litres of grain being pulled behind it. Yeah, I'm just really keen to get my hands on these trailers. So, yeah, fingers crossed we may actually get that get those trailers tomorrow, which would be awesome. And if we have to wait till Saturday, Sunday, or maybe beginning of next week, eh, so be it. You know, we know they're being tested right now. Black Sheep said that, but for some reason everyone just chose to ignore Black Sheep. And just kept asking, are they out now? Are they out now? Are they out now? Are they available yet? Are they available yet? Can we download these yet? It's just the same question over and over and over again. Hopefully Giant's thread, now that it's being spread around the groups, will help to stop these endless questions of, is this mod out yet? Or any new mods available today? Because it happens every group, every day. And it's usually the same people over and over again. Either have no patience to wait until they get home and load up the mod hub for themselves to check, or just can't be bothered to look for themselves. Hopefully this will help stop some of that incessant questioning of, is this out yet, is this out yet? You know, look at the thread, see what's being tested, and then you'll know that it's only a few days away. Can I drive through this fence? No, I can't. Just wondering if there was a way I could shortcut through here. It doesn't look like there is. No, that's all solid connections there. Okay, so we'll have to drive back around. But yeah, hopefully we're going to get those Mac trailers tomorrow. If not, maybe at the weekend, more likely, if we don't get them tomorrow. They're more likely we'll get them on Monday. on Tuesday. Like I said, cannot wait for those. Really looking forward to those. What else has gone live recently? Oh yes, the old stream has been updated. They have added in, God bless those guys at Black Sheep there. There's only three of them in the modding team. At least I think there's only three of them. They work so hard to just get this stuff out. They're just constantly churning out mod after mod after mod. The old stream has been expanded to add in three new crop fields, a new grass field, and they're all big fields. One of them in particular that you get given two of the three new grain fields, and the third one you can buy. The third one only costs like 247,000, I think it is. One of the ones that you get given is absolutely huge. It's a massive field for that map anyway. It's ginormous. Easily outstrips any of the other fields in terms of size. There's also a large placeable area that's been added in, so you can build a custom yard. It even has a couple of silage bunkers in that area as well, so you can actually make silage there. You've got no way of of shredding it there. You'd have to take it to the BGA to sell, or take it to the farm to use for your animals. But it's a great way of fermenting on another location. And then once it's done, you can just put it in trailers and take it back to your farm. I believe you can actually store silage in your silos on the old stream. I've never tried it, but I believe you can. And if not, you've got at least, even more space where you can, because there are three big silage bunkers already at the farm. You've got two more now where you can have, a large amount of silage. So that went live a couple of days ago. I have done a tour of that as well to show you the expansion. Again, you will need to do a brand new save file if you want to utilize the newer content. But do check that out on my channel. And I think there was something else as well that I was going to suggest, but I can't remember what. No, it's gone. Been playing a little bit of NBA 2K16 again recently, just to give me something a little bit different. Every now and again I just get the urge to play something sporty. I used to play a lot of FIFA and Pro Evo when I was younger. I don't really play them much anymore. I haven't owned a football game for quite a while now, actually. I don't know, I kind of lost interest in the console football games. I never really enjoyed playing them online anyway, because with a crap internet connection, you end up suffering lag, which makes you unplayable, or makes it unplayable. I'm a decent player, but I'm a decent player who doesn't do all the fancy tricksy stuff. So I can make decent runs, and I can play nice through balls, and I can score goals, but I don't do all the flicks and tricks and fancy stuff, that all the fancy footwork that dominates the online experience. If you don't know how to do that stuff, you get thrashed on a regular basis. And I like to play games to have fun, not to be constantly humiliated. So I don't generally tend to do much competitive play on any game anymore. I used to be I am a very competitive person, and I'm also autistic, so I have Asperger's. So I find it incredibly frustrating if I'm playing something competitively and I'm not doing well. I really get really frustrated and wound up, and tend to rage a lot, and it's It's not pretty, it's not nice to listen to. It can be funny at times, but it's not healthy. And my stress levels were just going through the roof. So I kind of just knocked it on the head. You know, modern gaming has evolved and I haven't really evolved with it as well as I probably could have and should have done. So the competitive stuff, I don't tend to do that often anymore. I still do from time to time, but not very often. Like I said, I tend to get wound up too easily, and like I said, I like to have fun and I like to enjoy the games I play. I don't play them to be, you know, frustrated and wound up and stressed. You know, it's different if you're playing a puzzle game and you're looking for something, or you're looking to play something challenging, and you know, it taxes you in that respect. But you know, in terms of just out and out frustration, I have no interest in putting myself through that anymore. So whereas I used to do a lot of, you know, first person shooters like Battlefield 3, I absolutely loved that and lived in it for, you know, a long time. You know, I didn't really enjoy Battlefield 4 that much. I didn't enjoy Battlefront. Both of those games had their issues with hacks and people using god cheats, which again just completely ruins the competitive experience. I used to play a fair bit of Grand Theft Auto online, but I got really frustrated with that because every time they release new content, you want to try it out, but you're forced to be in a public session. And you know, as the game is getting older, there are less and less people who want to play the game just for playing the game. And more of the people that are still playing the game are trolls and are there just to wind you up and hunt you down and make your life a misery. And again, I have very little time for that, so I've kind of stopped playing that as well. It worries me for Red Dead Redemption, because I know that Red Dead Online is going to be a thing, and it kind of worries me as to just how trolly that's going to be when the Grand Theft Auto game is just gravitate over to Red Dead Redemption 2 later this year. But, we'll have to see how things go nearer the time. Anyway, I'm going to wrap it up here. That's all for this episode. Thank you all for watching. My name's Jim Bob, and I will catch you back on the farm very soon.